right there about dedicating that Gracie Award to Breonna Taylor. There's been a lot of changes, a lot of push for social justice in this country. So we're going to talk to Tamron about that right now. She's here to tell us all about it. Tamron, it's always good to talk to you. Happy Friday.
Hi. Thank you. Happy Friday, Wisdom. Good to see you.
Good to see you and good to talk to you. So tell us a little bit about why you decided to dedicate your Gracie Award to Breonna Taylor.
Honestly, Wisdom, it wasn't even something that I planned. The Gracies were online, like so many other award shows, and they asked me to tape an acceptance speech. And I didn't write anything down. To be honest, my husband had set up the iPad, and the words just flowed from my heart. What's happened in that case, I struggle to understand, like so many other people. The details that I've read don't lead to, or shouldn't lead. I did a crime show for many years. I've been a journalist for 27 years. And the fact that we are still grappling with why there is no justice for this young woman who did nothing wrong, it tears at my heart. And this Gracie Award is given by women in the media. And I feel that as women in the media, Black, white, Latino, Asian, if we don't speak up for each other, and if we don't make sure that the stories of women that may not live next door to us are heard, then are we really using our power? So much that we've talked about the Me Too movement, women's empowerment. If you don't use your power to help someone else, do you really have power? So in that moment, I don't feel like a powerful person, but I have a big platform, and I wanted to remind myself and the people watching that we can't forget women like Breonna Taylor,
right.
Women who've been silenced, and that's honestly what happened.
Right, and let's talk about your platform, because you are using your platform to tell stories. You're about to kick off another season.
Can you believe it? And we're back in studio. Last time I talked to you, I was in the basement on an iPad. And now we're in the studio. You know, I said, I don't feel like we've come back. I feel like we never left, like so many of you. You're in your home working. There's no separation between work and home. It's all just, I told someone, they said, life is just one big nap. We nap and we get back up. We nap and we get back up, because we're on this cycle together. But we're back in studio, kicking off this season 2 of the show, with exciting guests, big conversations. But I think more than anything, the spirit of the ability just to talk about it, to laugh together, to talk together, to cry together, the same things you and I have done over the first season, it's right. A continuation of that.
All right. So look, I want to talk about you got a birthday celebration. And
yes.
Before we go, you got a birthday celebration, and my man Moses is doing some swimming. So you got to get both of those in before we get out there.
Swimming. Moses is 16 months, he is swimming, although I just got a text message from my husband. He fell down and bumped his head on the sofa, so that's why I was halfway looking at you and halfway looking at this. It's like life is so real with a 16-month-old who's walking. I'm like, dude, you can swim, but you can't walk and not fall into the sofa. What is really going on? So he's doing great. He's talking. He can't wait to be, you know, for Uncle Wisdom to babysit him. All these things are coming in his future. Oh, yes!
Angie Goff is over here. She wants to jump in on this interview so bad.
I know.
Listen, Angie, if you can teach me how to keep my... Two things. I don't know what proper size to buy of crayons for a 16-month-old. You know how many times I Googled that last night? What size crayons do you give a 16-month-old? And how do you keep a 16-month-old from just randomly falling? I have padding. My house is padded everywhere.
You know,
and
you crate them. You put
How
them in
do
a
you
crate.
Fall on a
do you
pad
have a crate
and get a bump?
Yeah,
you know,
Angie's over here talking
what
about crating people.
You know,
but
crate train them.
Here's the thing. Angie's is in here talking about crating kids now. But here's
I'm
the thing, Tamron.
Angie, you're trying to get me arrested.
No, yeah, exactly.
I'm just starting season 2. I don't want to be in cuffs.
Right.
You know, by the way, I'm so excited about season 2. You know, I talked to you before. I'm here for this. I'm here for this interview.
Look. Here's the thing, Tamron. Angie is over here trying to, you know, do this thing with kids. Just let them fall. That's what they do. I got 3. She's got 3.
Let them fall.
Yeah, let them fall. It makes them tougher.
They're made out of cartilage at this point.
Yeah, they fall. They get back up.
No, I am going to get a full... I'm getting an NFL football uniform. I'm going to put the child in it, and then he's not going to get out of it until he's at least 5. Because every time I look up, I'm saying, what? How did he fall? My husband, the other night, I had to run out and do something for work. I wasn't gone 2 hours. My husband called. He fell down. He slipped up. What? So it's just, yes. So to answer your question, Moses is full of bumps and bruises, but he's still standing, like the rest of us.
Tim, news alert, that's going to happen for the rest of your life. The moment you leave, within 2 hours, you will get a call for something.
I dove down the steps one time because my young child was falling down the steps. My crazy self jumped down the steps trying to catch him. I was the only one hurt.
That's what we do.
That's why you walk with a limp.
That's why I walk with a limp.
You need to train my husband in wisdom. You need to train my husband because I'm with Andrew. I leave the house not a second, and I have. That's why I have an iWatch now.
Right.
I've got the phone because it's just all day.
Yeah,
all
I understand. Day long. I understand. But yeah. You got work to do. You got other work to do.
We're
gonna let you go. We're gonna let you go. Tamron, always good to see
you.
We love you. We love you. All right. You can catch Tamron Hall weekdays at 1 p.m. right here on Fox 5.